Hey everybody, I'm going to do another review, but I just want to do a gun I've already done before, but the video wasn't that good, and it'll be on my Husqvarna 22 single shots, and a lot of people complained I couldn't hear what I was saying and all this stuff, but you know how it is. Anyway, so I figured I'd just go over it again, and since now I own like a couple of them, a better sort of overview of the different ones they made and stuff like that, the different features on the different models, and so we'll get right into it. So this one, this one's a model 55, I believe, from what I can find on the internet, and one that makes this one a model 55 is apparently they all have straight English stocks like this, no pistol grip. There's no checkering or anything, they're plain. They have the straight bolt handle, which is similar to all of them, but they have the auto safety on them on the side here, and I'll show you how that works in a second. They have octagon barrels. I believe all the 55s have octagons, but I think the ones that have round barrels on them are ones that were replaced. I've seen a couple like that, and they got fixed V sights. They're 50 meters on this one, but also another one I have. It's a like these are in 22 long rifle, but the other one I have is in 22 long, and its sight is lower, and I think it's like a 25 or 20 meter fixed sight. So there's a little variation there, but they're octagon. They're, I think they're 23 inches or so, or 600 millimeters, or however it was. And then you get like a simple V front sight. There's no real crowning, it's sort of just lopped off. You have sling swivels on these. I think some of them didn't. So I think some of these, it makes them like a 55A, or I forget how they went about it, but there's a website there. If you type in Husqvarna serial numbers, like the first website there in Google, it's a site there where the guy has a list of like all the commercial rifles they built, and it gives you a little bit of a general, like what the different differences are between them and the model numbers and what they were, their name in Swedish is and stuff like that. So it's kind of neat, and they have the serial number database or a cross section of it, and it sort of gives you an idea of when these guns were built. So I think that was kind of neat, because some of these are quite old. Like I think the Model 55 came out around 1907 or so. But so anyway, you know, so how the auto safety works. Like there's no real manual safety. It's like as soon as you cock the bolt, the safety is engaged. So you gotta push it from the back. It's like sort of like teeter-totter kind of thing. You push it from the back and it'll click, because it was holding, it grabbed a hold of this back of the cocking piece or the side of it here. So then it's, you can pull the trigger now. But you can see, like on the bottom here is where your sear grabs. There's also a channel on the side of the bolt here, and that's where the safety goes. The safety grabs it, and the safety is just a tiny bit like longer or ahead of the normal sear, so it grabs it first and holds it away from the sear, because you don't want the like you wouldn't want like if you cocked it and pulled the trigger, and the trigger was the same distance as the safety was. You pulled the trigger, and it might get stuck or caught up. So then, when you took the safety off, bang, she'd go off on you. So that's one thing to look for on these. I think it was this one, or I'm not sure if it was this one or not, but this one had a little bit of a problem that way. If you cock it and you pull the trigger, and the trigger would get kind of half stuck, and sometimes it would stick back, so I had to do a little bit of filing there to correct that. But, But it's kind of a neat feature anyway, and it's probably a good thing that for a gun that was intended for youth and stuff like that. But so that's the model 55. Then there's a model 155, which is basically, I think it's similar as this, but they didn't have the manual safety or the auto safety, but had the same sort of stock, and they finally had a adjustable sight on it. So that's more similar to this one here. This one's the 255. It was basically the last one they built for the single shot 22 goes. So you can see it has a pistol grip. It's a plain stock. There's no check or anything, but there's variations on all these models. Like some have checkering. Some had little differences with the bolts and stuff. Like this one's straight, but there was one with it was bent down for some reason. And this one, there was a 155, was a straight stock, and it had octagon barrels, but I don't think the 255s ever had an octagon barrel. They're always in the round. These were some of the last ones that I said they were made. They were made during the war into the 50s. I think this one here is from 1950, I believe, if I remember right, because I looked at the serial number, but somewhere around there, late 40s or 1950, something like that. To get your pistol grip, you got your plain stock. This one has sling swivels, but I think this model had ones without sling swivels as well. Adjustable sight, as I said, this one goes, it's 20, like they have the elevator, and then there's numbers written on the barrel here. You got 20 meters, 50 meters, 100 meters, and 200 meters. And 200 is kind of optimistic for anything, but it would be kind of neat to find out if it actually, if you knew what something where it was 200 meters, like a gong or something, if you got to get hit it. Because it, like, all the other ranges are right on as far, like, for a standard 22 ammo goes. Like, it even says, it says ABSET for 22 long rifle. ABSET must be sighted in for or whatever. So it's, like, standard 22 long rifle, like, 40 grain bullet going, what's it, 1150 or so, 1200, so you're using your standard 22 ammo that's loaded like all over the friggin' world, and it's kind of a 22 is kind of cool like that. Like it's quite like ammo's loaded like all kinds of different friggin' countries, but they'll basically, from any ammo you can find anywhere, loaded anywhere at any time, basically will work at most guns that are sighted this kind of way, or I find it anyway. But so like the 20 meter one works, and these kind of correspond to like 25 yards, 50 yards, 100 yards, but they do up to 100 meters, it's right on. So I imagine the 200 is close, but you can see that it's you click up to 100 and then 200 is way the hell up here. So but anyway, so you get your adjustable sight, and it's got a sort of a, these are a stamped kind of back sight, and they got a smaller V, which is better in some ways, and then you got a big blade front sight, which is actually better than the old V sights, but you kind of need something like that for if you're shooting longer ranges. But the most 22s for hunting, they're basically a 50 yard gun or a 50 meter gun, but it's kind of nice to have settings where if you want to just do some plinking or whatever, something that's 100 yards away, I put a swinging gong down at 100 and I can hit it pretty much every time with this. So it's kind of a nice thing to have. Like I know some of the North American made 22s, they have the same sort of back sight with the little elevator and stuff, but there's no markings to tell you like what it means or where the different, you know, ranges are and stuff. So it's kind of useless, really, unless you go to the range and figure out what it's doing. But this one actually tells you. So, and this is Sackrat, or however that's pronounced. I think that must mean like youth, or God knows what it is. Maybe someone from Sweden can don't know what that means. S-A-K-R-A-T. It looks like sack rat. But, so you got your basically your bolt handle is exactly the same, but it has the manual safety on the side. And, you can see that, like, it has the thing for the sear, but there's no channel on the side for the auto safety anymore. And the placement of the firing pin and extractor are a little bit different on these ones. I believe it is on this one, anyway. So, yeah, see, this one, the extractor is on the bottom. This one's on the extractor on the bottom, but the firing pin is on the top, like 9 degrees over. Yeah, totally opposite from it. And, yeah, like 180 degrees from it. And this one's just to the side of it, like here. So I don't know if there's a big difference, but there's a couple different variations. But it just makes it a little, at least with this one, I think the pin that holds the extractor holds the firing pin, but this one has two different pins because they're totally opposite from each other. But everything else is basically the same on it. I mean, the way it works inside is the same. But this one doesn't have a auto safety. This one's got a manual safety on the side here, and it's being European, it's backwards. Forward is safe. And then flip it back, and it's off. But there's also a little difference the way the barrel is. The older ones, the barrel is almost right back here. You can see with this one, it's inset a little bit because I added gas ports. There's a hole on this side and a hole on this side. There's a big scallop cut just behind the barrel here in case you have a head, like being a rim fire, sometimes the rim can rupture when you fire it. The brass isn't annealed properly or hardened or whatever. Sometimes if it does happen even with modern ammo, but so usually notice the gas will come, it'll go out the sides instead of coming back around. But they must have thought it was a problem because they added that on. And I guess some ammo in the old days wasn't the greatest, but actually now I think most bulk ammo you buy now is worse than ammo you bought back in the 50s. But this damn stuff blows back. It doesn't have to rupture, just the ammo is bloody weak and stuff like that. The case doesn't swell up enough to seal it, and then it leaks back around. And that's to do with, I guess, with improperly annealed brass, or the brass is too friggin' hard or something, and it just doesn't swell up. And I think I mentioned that in my did a video on 22 ammo. I did different accuracy tests and stuff. I think I went over that. But so yeah, that's basically the big difference between the different models, and a little review on it. This one here, the rifling on this one are big, wide, flat rifling, where this older one here has sort of like mini or micro rifling, or kind of like reminds me of like the rifling that are in the Marlin rifles there. They're a little small, and a whole bunch of them kind of deal. Well, there's not a whole lot of them, but they're smaller. There's more of them than there is in this one. But I find this one, overall, I found this becomes more accurate, but none has anything to do with the age of that one being way older. But I did find this one, the rifling in this barrel was more accurate with a wider range of ammo than some of the other ones. They seemed like they liked one kind of ammo, and then other ones they didn't, weren't a big fan of. But so, anyway, I'm bored the hell out of you. So anyway, take it easy, and we'll see you in the next video.